we're going to teach you how to set up ExpressVPN for your iPhone or iPad that will allow you to browse privately with ultra-secure VPN protection. But before we begin the setup, please hit the subscribe button below, share this video, and like it. We've also left a special link in the description below so you can get discounted rates. It's easy to set up ExpressVPN on iOS 10 or higher. First, download the ExpressVPN app from the App Store. Just search ExpressVPN and tap Get from the app page. If you can't find the app, you may need to switch your App Store country. Once the app is downloaded and installed, open it up. There should be an option to sign in from the welcome screen. You have two options here. If you don't have an App Store subscription, just enter the email address and password for your ExpressVPN account, tap the sign in button, and you're good to go. If you do have an App Store subscription, tap the Restore to your App Store subscription button. You may be asked to enter your Apple ID password. Next, you'll see a little statement from ExpressVPN about the information they collect. Read it if you want to. Otherwise, tap Agree and continue to move on. Now here's where you get to the actual setup of your VPN. You should see a message saying that your device will ask for permission to complete the configuration. Just tap Continue to move on to the next step. This should prompt a dialog box that says ExpressVPN wants to add VPN configurations. Tap Allow. Next, you'll need to enter your phone's passcode or your Touch ID. The next step is all about notifications. ExpressVPN can let you know about important alerts and announcements. If you'd like to receive these alerts, tap OK. Otherwise, tap No Thanks. ExpressVPN only sends alerts related to your VPN account and connection. They can be useful, but they're not necessary to use the app. Once you select your preference, ExpressVPN will ask you whether you want to share anonymous data with them, like crash reports, usability diagnostics, and speed tests. These reports never include any personally identifiable information. It's up to you whether you want to share any data. Tap OK to agree, or tap No Thanks to opt out. Now you can finally connect to a VPN server. Just tap the power button to get started. ExpressVPN will suggest an optimal location, which is what they call a smart location. You can choose to connect to this location, or you can choose a different one. Just tap the three dots next to the smart location bubble to view your options. ExpressVPN has more than 3,000 servers in 94 countries, so there's no shortage of options. Your list should include recommended locations, but you can choose any location you want. Once you're connected to a server, it should say connected, and the background should switch to a green color. An ExpressVPN connection allows you to connect up to 5 devices at once. Along with changing your server's location, ExpressVPN also allows you to change your VPN protocol. The app chooses the most appropriate protocol automatically, but if you want to change it manually, you can. You'll need to be disconnected to do this. To disconnect, just tap the power button again. It should say that you're not connected. To change protocols, navigate to Options, Settings, VPN Protocol. From here, you can choose from Automatic, UDP, TCP, and IKEV2. There's really no reason not to use the automatic option. If you're not familiar with VPN protocols, we recommend just leaving it on the default setting. That's all there is to it. Once you've chosen a server and tapped the connect button, you're ready to start using apps securely on your iOS device. Try it yourself by clicking on the link below to access your special discounted rate just for you. Thanks again for watching our video on how to set up ExpressVPN for iOS. If you like this video, please click the subscribe button below. Like this video and share it with others.